Hey, have you come across any scenario that you have a one placement but you want to load multiple types of component? And we call that dynamic component loading or dynamic component allocation. So let's solve that in this video. Hi everyone, this is Subrat and you are watching Fun of Heuristic. So on this channel, we'll make videos like this, which is related to programming and web development. So please consider subscribing and hit the bell icon if you haven't yet. Long back, I had made a video about dynamic component loading or dynamic component allocation, but lot of things has been changed since then. And I just want to reiterate through this video because I'm getting still lot of comments on that how to do this and all, and this might solve a lot of the problem. And in this video, we're going to see how to do that in a newer way. To make this video small, I have done some basic configuration. I will so explain them. Then we'll go to the main implementation of dynamic component loading. So if we go to a system, so here, if you can see, I have created three components, which is Java, JavaScript, and Rust. And I just want to say that all the components we are using or all the projects from now onwards, it will be standalone components. So I'm just saying that so that you'll know that this is a standalone. So there is some imports and things will be different if you're not going by standalone. So we have three components like Java, JavaScript, and Rust. And I will explain like why I have given the data and name and why the input and all. So I have created a service, which is dynamic component service, where we have get dynamic components, which is just returning three dynamic components here. Here you can think a scenario like you are getting a response from your backend, and from that response, you are structuring all your dynamic components, how it should look, and returning back to your component. So here we have a class called dynamic item. If you go inside that, we have two properties in them. So one is component, which can be type of any component, or you can specify which components you want if you know your scenarios. And I'm just getting a data as any. Again, here you should not give any. For the sake of the video, I'm just giving any, but you can specify which data type you want as an input to those components. So if you see here, I have data here, and I'm just taking this as an input to the Rust component, Java component, and JavaScript component. And you ask me why we are using data and why we are using this implementing dynamic component here, because when you load a component, your reference should point to a similar type of record. And that's why the inheritance will help us here. We'll say all the component, Rust, Java, or JavaScript, will implement our dynamic component. And the dynamic component will have a data type of any, and the name is data. You can put multiple data here, which can be used as a multiple input to your multiple component, and it can be optional or it can be mandatory. So here it's mandatory, but you can put a optional like this also. So I have created a dynamic wrapper, which will take an input of all the dynamic components you want to load, which you'll get from our dynamic service. And we are using our dynamic service inside our app component. We have a inject here of dynamic service, and I'm getting all the components from our get dynamic components. And I'm passing this to our app dynamic wrapper as an input, as a dynamic components input. And if you'll go inside this, so here, if you see, we got our dynamic components. This is the setup. This is the basic setup you need. So first thing first, to load something dynamically, you need a reference of where you're going to load them. So for that, we'll add a view child here. So this view child, and we'll have a DC directive, which we have already created. And we'll add the wrapper in our HTML. Now we'll go to our HTML. And here, I will add our ng template with DC wrapper as a directive. And if you'll go inside DC wrapper, this is a simple directive which is standalone true because we are using standalone everywhere. And we are saying our directive selector should be DC wrapper, and it's using ViewContainerRef reference. We have used this DC wrapper in our ng template. Now we'll use this ng template placement to load our dynamic component. And to load, I'll go ahead and add a method like this. We have a method called load component, which will accept a item, which is our dynamic item, means one of the item from our input, which we are getting as input from our app component. And what we'll do here, we'll access this DC wrapper first, means DC wrapper directive, and we get the view container reference. We'll clear that just to make sure that is clear, and we'll load one more component here. And we are saying that view container reference will create a component, and the type of our components will be our dynamic component, which would be the parent of all of your dynamic component which need to be loaded. That's why I have said in the beginning that you need to have a type or need to have a parent or all of your dynamic components. So we are passing the component, and we are passing the instance dot data to our data. So what will happen here? So whenever you will call your load component with a particular component inside it, so whenever you get that, then you will clear the previous container reference. Then you create a component and assign that to the container reference, and then assign the data which you want as an input or something, okay? And to trigger this load component method, I'll create some button and pass our items to it. So we'll go to HTML, and here you can do this. I'm just iterating over the input which we got from our app component and from our service, and just rendering a button, and the text of the button should be like our name which we are getting from our service, which is this, and we are calling load component method, and that's all. If we'll go to the application now, we'll see that we have three buttons, which is Java, Rust, and JavaScript, and which is coming from our respective dynamic item. On click of that, we are rendering them like Java, Rust, and JavaScript. So here I have added two lines in Rust just to show you that your data can be anything. Your data means your input type can be anything. If you'll go inside this, so here if I check, my dynamic item has the component, the Rust component, and in the data we are passing name and description. I have given this data as any, of type any, but you can give as a union type and pass your component data accordingly. So here, as you are passing name and description, the same we are reading it inside our Rust component, which name and description, and that is being displayed here. So my point here is, you can load as many type of component as you want in a single place by using dynamic loading. That's how you will load your component dynamically in a better way or in an efficient way. So I will just try to recap. So we'll go to our component. So in our app component, we are using our service, which is giving us the list of components we want to load. So if we'll go inside our method, which is present in the service, we are returning a list of dynamic items which we can load. And one of our items, means one of our dynamic item, contained a component which we want to load dynamically, and the data we want to provide to that component. So we are passing that, and this data, these components, we are passing as an input to our dynamic component wrapper. And in that dynamic component wrapper, we are calling a method called load component on click of each component's button. And in that, we are passing the item which we are getting from the input. So inside the load component method, we are creating a view container reference from the directive which we have used in our ng template, because this is the placement where you want to render your dynamic component. So we are accessing that. Clearing that reference means now we can load a new component in it, and we are using that reference to create a component, and we are providing that type as our dynamic component, because this dynamic component is the parent of all of the dynamic components which we want to load, and passing the component to it so that it can be created, and passing the input data to it. If I'll just go inside dynamic component, so it's just an interface with data. And this interface has been used by our Rust component or our JavaScript component or our Java component. All three are using them. So this is how you can use the power of inheritance and power of view content reference and create a dynamic component and render it however you like. So please hit the like button if you like the video till now. Please do subscribe to the channel and don't forget to hit the bell icon so that you will not miss future videos. Please do share this video among your friends, family, colleagues so that they will also going to use dynamic component in their projects. We're going to meet in the next video. Till then, stay happy. Bye-bye.